what actually happened in the Youngstown area to cause the earthquakes? Something wrong?
Well, we're looking down several thousand feet. There's no absolute certainty. But the speculation is that highly probable, likely, that the injection, the drill hole intersected the fracture zone. As I said, in a very pretty unique situation. And they injected the fluid in, and near the fracture zone. But there's still some question and debate amongst scientists as to whether or not it is, it's causing the lubrication of the fracture zone, the fault zone, or whether or not it is the additional weight and volume and pressure that's causing that particular fracture zone to slip. But in general, I think it's pretty much generally agreed that the mechanism is from the wells and into the basement and drilling into the basement, whether it's exacerbated or wrong.
Thank you. And I think this question sums up for a lot of people. Is our water aquifers actually in danger? Is our water aquifers, or the water that we have, is there any danger at all?
There's always danger. Anytime you do a process, anytime you do those things, there's risk associated with it. The risk is minimal. The wells are designed in a way where certain strengths of pipe, we term them casing, are required to be installed from surface through the water. Ohio adopted the Safe Drinking Water Act definition of drinking water. We protect water in Ohio to a standard of 10,000 milligrams per liter TDS. That quality of water is not necessarily potable water. It could potentially be treated, but nobody here would drink that water as their primary water source. So we protect the water that is not of high quality. So we go through the high quality water to the lower quality water and then require the casing to be set. Our inspectors are on site to witness the placement, the condition of the pipe, and then the cementing of the pipe. And then as each additional string of casing is placed in that well, we are there to approve that. If there are any problems with it, then we cause the company to remediate it before they go on. And then if a remediation, in our opinion, cannot be achieved, then we have authority to cause the well to flow. Since 1983, we've been running the federal program in Ohio, and the injection process has not contaminated groundwater.
The serving book that we are here in our Richmond County and the city of Mansfield, our position on behalf of the city is that we believe that there is an unreasonable risk to our water for the following reasons. And possibly the professor could explain ramifications of the concept of vertical percolation. But we are not opposed to business, we are not opposed to commerce. The problem is that when you drill down into an area, you really don't know what's down. You just do not know. It's like in Youngstown, there's an opinion as to what may have caused it. Nobody really knows. So our concern is that if you take the concept that water seeks its path of least resistance, and the deeper you go in fluids, the greater the pressure. And that therefore means that if you don't know fractures or pulse down there, and if the waste is absorbed through sandstone and it continues in areas that nobody really knows about, then there's a possibility of vertical percolation. Could you possibly expand on this?
Yes.
Very slight pressure pushing
water builds on and vertical. I would say that one of the things that can be done in the situation of injection wells, as I suggested in my talk, is to have a separate monitoring well tuned into only in the fresh water to monitor whether or not the process of casing failure or something that can cause the water to migrate out of the injection.
Thank you.
We were just informed that there has to be a car moved.
What car?
They know the name of the individual. Olga Shabonsky has to move her car. She's blocking somebody else in. So if you could do that. Next question we have is, what's the integrity or the risk of the integrity of the wells if there are earthquakes of 4.0 magnitude?
The wells are designed to withstand 4.0 or even higher earthquakes. We don't have a lot of large earthquakes in Ohio, but the ones we have not damaged any wells, and we do monitor the construction of the well, as I said, about every 11 to 12 weeks. We do monitor the groundwater, but we monitor the groundwater sooner than it may reach a monitored well that's drilled into the aquifer. We monitor it by monitoring the casing pressures, the induced pressures that the required company put on the well itself, to see if they indeed are leaking. So we look for leaks first at the well, so that if a fluid were to migrate vertically, then we can stop it before it affected the environment.
I would like to ask the representative from DNR what studies have been done by the DNR to determine that there's been no damage to the infrastructure of the city of Youngstown or to the foundations of the people who have homes in the area of the tremors. As we know, we're not talking about an earthquake for the 07 catastrophic major damage to homes. But if you start the process of compromising the foundation of a home, it may take 3, 4, 5, 10 years. That process could destroy the foundation of a home. So what studies has ODNR done to determine or to make representations that no damage resulted from these earthquakes?
ODNR doesn't go out and do a seismic assessment after a seismic event. We collect the data. We analyze the data as the professor described, and then we use that data to help evaluate first whether a well should remain in a particular area, and second, if a well is proposed for a certain area, if it should have a different construction criteria. But we don't go to a structure level